Want a new idea to help you get fit? How about buy a dog? Back with us today is the fitness nomad, John Ashworth, to explain how a family pet can motivate you to get in shape. And you and your family recently got Allie.
That's right, here she is.
Good girl. Oh, I know, I can't reach. You, oh, she's so cute. You recently got her. How did your lives change, fitness-wise?
Well, I'll tell you what, we've been doing a lot more walking. We've been doing a ton of walking, myself and the kids and Laura included. I just can't believe how much more we've walked since we got the dog.
You have a program on your iPad that actually allows you to track how much you're walking.
Right. So I've been tracking the walks since we got Allie in mid-December and took a look at the data here this morning in preparation for the segment. And I couldn't believe. It's almost 30 miles a month the last 2 months. 80% or better of these walks, this is since December. So on the far left here is December, and here we are in the current month in August, and we're at about 25 miles. I'm going for 40 this month. So at any rate, I couldn't believe how much more walking. 80% or more of this activity is strictly because we have the dog now.
So is this taking the place of exercise, or this is in addition to your routine?
It's a little bit of both.
Okay.
So I'm definitely doing more walking than I would have done otherwise, by far, mm-hmm. because we have the dog. And definitely during the winter when it's cold and you really don't want to go outside, the dog has to go.
Yeah, right. So you have to make yourself.
So you have to go.
How many miles a week you walk, you think?
Well, it works out to about 8 to 10 miles a week right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Which will be a lot more than somebody who doesn't have any exercise plan, and it's because you want to take care of your pet.
Right.
What have you learned? You have on your blog a list of 6 things, and I pulled a couple for our viewers at home to take a look here. Some different lessons you've learned.
Well, one of them is I just couldn't believe how much more walking and exercise I was getting as a result of having the pet. The second thing I learned was the value, just again, even though I already understand the value, I recommend my clients do this, of tracking what you're doing. Because that did a variety of things for me. I looked at this today and I thought, wow, that really motivated me. That's a sense of accomplishment, all this walking that I've done. Now I can look at the data, I can look at the last 2 months and say, well, I've almost gotten to 40 miles. Let's make 40 miles happen in August, so it's a little bit of a motivator to keep me going. Now I can look back over the course of the whole year and set new goals for this year. Those are some of the things.
And do you see this affecting your wife or your children in the same way as far as their fitness and goals?
Yeah, definitely. Laura more so than the kids, because we're still trying to get them in the habit of taking the dog out for a more walk.
Of course. But you think that it translates for the entire family, not just maybe the one person who really wanted the dog, but everybody taking some responsibility.
Yeah, it's definitely a team effort, which is the way I think it should be.
Yeah, I wonder, because a lot of families, you know, talk about getting pets, and this might be a good way to get your children to learn responsibility and also get some exercise.
Right.
How much do you think the kids could participate in a safe way?
Well, I think, you know, they're probably getting 3 miles a week of walking in additional. They have to learn how to gather the things together, take the dog out for a walk, you know, be mindful of what's going on. There's definitely a more of a sense of responsibility that we've been able to teach them since having the dog, which has been good as well. Yeah.
Allie, are you a good girl?
Yeah, very good.
Are you going to get your daddy in shape? She's like, I want a nap.
Right.
That's the other thing. Then you get to relax more when you're done, right?
That's right. That's right. Dogs, you take a nap with your dog when you're done.
The perfect life. Well, John, thank you so much. It's really a great idea and simple for a lot of people who might already have pets to just maybe take that walk a little more seriously and get a workout.
Yeah, get those 5 or 10 miles a week.
I'll tell you what. I take my dog to the dog park. Love it, and so does she. We have so much fun together. Yeah. If you would like to read John's blog on how Allie has helped his family get in shape or give you some ideas for yourself, log on to our web channel and click on News Links. We'll be right back.